Welcome to Springwell's first ever live broadcast. I'm Charlie Flynn in Year 9.
And I'm Joss Holmes, also in Year 9. And together we bring you Springwell TV. Mrs. Burnside would like to welcome you to our college and to a first ever news bulletin. Over to you, Miss Burnside.
Hello, it gives me great pleasure to introduce you to the very first Springwell news bulletin. I've been at the Springwell for a year now, and over that year we've made some massive changes, moving from the older building, the dull, grey, lifeless buildings that we were in, to coming into this brand new, spectacular, state-of-the-art facilities. The results that we achieved last year were brilliant, the best results ever for 3 years running at 75% 5A disease. This year we look forward to developing the use of the whole of the college as a learning environment, developing the standards of teaching and learning even further so we can yet again excel the best results ever, this time with 5A's to C's and 5A's to C's including English and Maths. I'm really looking forward to the year ahead.
After months of watching the new college being built, we have finally moved in at the beginning of November 2010.
We were all amazed at the facilities available to us. This short video clip shows the process of the college build.
You raise me up, so I can't stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
The landscaping of the site was still being completed during the first 6 months of us being in the college, and so our official opening took place upon completion in July 2011.
We held the celebration day open to all past students, staff, parents and official delegates.
Councillor Walter Burrows and Councillor John Williams unveiled the plaque after a stunning performance from our students of the recent Rock Challenge.
It was fantastic to see all our community together to celebrate this special event.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night.
The college continues its celebrations on Saturday the 16th of July, when we held our very own first Family Fun Day. Despite the rain, over 1,000 people joined in the fun and everyone had a ball. From pizza throwing to bungee jumps, fancy dress to charity stores, Zumba to bingo and beauty treatments to Paralympic activities, this event had it all for everyone.
Shake that.
She on my jock, huh? Now stop when we in the spot. Booty moving weight like she on the block. With a drink, I got to know. Tight jeans, tattoo, cause I'm rockin' wrong. Half black, half white, diamond low. Gang of money, open door. Yeah, I'm running
through these halls like Trano. We have been in the college for 1 year. and we could proudly say the buildings look good as just they did on day one. Happy birthday, Springwell.
We are also proud of how our students look in their smart new uniforms. This includes the introduction of the school blazer, college skirt and the clip-on tie. As part of our Healthy Schools initiative to promote healthy eating and exercise, Mr. Brian Keir, the Chartwell's Regional Manager, organised for students to have a go on a smoothie bike.
Earlier this term, I had the opportunity to catch up with Mr. Keir and ask him a few questions.
Did students participate and enjoy having a go on smoothie bike?
Yeah, certainly seem to. We've been doing it now for a couple of days and we're starting to get a good crowd around at lunchtimes. And everyone seems to want to either have a go on the bike or certainly to try the smoothies.
What goes into the smoothies?
Very simple. Fresh fruit, chopped up. Particularly bananas, but that adds a lot of body. Some yogurt and some fruit juice. So no added sugar, no added fat. It's just pure natural products.
How do you think it will improve school health?
Well, hopefully we're trying to show that, drinks can taste nice when they're just made out of. You don't have to have sugary, fizzy drinks. You can have nice tasting, good, healthy drinks just made out of fresh products.
How many schools have you been to?
This is the first time I've done it. This is the first school I've done it in. We've got 10 bikes in the company, and we've got about 2,000 schools. So they basically rotate around the schools as people want.
Do you think it's popular?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, I think everybody likes to join in. Everyone wants to have a go at on the bike or to try the brake, yeah.
How did you modify the bike?
It's a standard mountain bike. We put a rack on the back wheel, so the back wheel's off the ground. And then you actually buy the piece of kit that the liquidizer goes on. You just attach it. And so the bike wheel turns, it turns the spindle in the... in the piece of kit, and that turns the blades in the liquidizer.
Anything to say
about? No, just delighted to have a chance to bring it to Springwell. I'd say the level of participation has been great. We're about to go out and have another lunchtime session. So hopefully we'll see you all out there.
Thank you.
And finally, we go over to Bethany in the dance studio for an interview with Miss Hoyle about the Rock Challenge competition which occurred earlier in the year.
How's taking the time to talk to us about Rock Challenge? Firstly, can you tell us what Rock Challenge actually is?
Rock Challenge is a national and also global competition that encourages students to get a natural free high involved within a performance. They get involved with the whole production of it, so we're looking at the set design, the lighting, the choreography and the final finishing touches to the performance.
How did we as a school become involved?
Once upon a time, Mrs. Rain asked me to go onto a course. She'd heard about this project and we went to it, and it was the first time it was ever coming to Derby. So they were trying to get as many schools within the local area involved in the project. Once that happened, I came back to school and was obviously buzzing with the fact that we could produce such a fabulous performance. And then I just asked who wanted to get involved with the students.
How did students get involved?
So I asked them first of all who wanted to take part practically, and then we asked who wanted to get involved with backstage, and then we just continued to roll with the choreography and the ideas and managed to produce an 8-minute performance.
How many students have participated?
The first year there was 30, and that included the performers and the backstage people involved. The second year, because of our success, it rocketed to actually 125 students in total. And then last year I had 75 students taking part in the competition.
How many schools did we compete in?
Usually when we go to the heat, it's just 5 or 6, depending on who's getting involved that year. But always when we go to the national finals, it runs over 2 days. And on your particular day, you're competing against 11 other schools up and down the country. So that includes those from Ireland and obviously Wales and Scotland. So it's quite a far afield.
How do you come up with the theme for the performances?
The first year was I was inspired by a television advert of Think Before You Drink. The second year was actually a student's idea of how we treat others, how we want to be treated ourselves. And then the last year was obviously our massive move over to the new college, and we looked at the traditional ways of teaching and how we've evolved as a school into ways that suit the students' needs.
How long does it take to create a performance?
The first ever year, it only took 8 weeks, which kind of blows me away a little bit that we managed to do it in such a short space of time. But over the last two productions, it's taken a good 6 months from the first creative ideas to the actual finished performance.
Who makes all the set and costumes?
It's a massive team effort, and without help and support of other members of staff like Mr. League and Mrs. Hurt, then we wouldn't have produced half the amount of set and costume. Usually a number of staff get involved and the students pitch in within their half terms to create all the set and the costumes and everything.
What awards have we won in the past?
We've won a fair few. They range from best set design, best costume, best lighting. We've won most entertaining performance. And without Mr. Drennan's help last year, we wouldn't have won best soundtrack. We've come first in the Derby events over the last 3 years, and we've also come fifth in the Northern Open final.
What's the most memorable moment for you?
Without a doubt, it's got to be winning the Derby Heat last year, because we went there as underdogs because we weren't there the year before, so we knew the competition was going to be tough. And when we got to the event, we actually realised just how tough it was. So it was just a moment that I know that a lot of people are going to treasure for the rest of their lives.
Does the competition have a positive impact on students?
I like to think so, because seeing their faces after every performance, I know that they're just buzzing. It's great to see that everyone gets involved. There's a massive team effort, and it's really good to see the older students acting as role models for the lower end of the school.
We'll be taking part next year, and how can people get involved?
I hope so. If they want to get involved, auditions will be held at the beginning of next year. Those who want to take part practically, and a little later on, there'll be meetings held for those who want to get involved backstage. So fingers crossed it all does.
Is there any final comments you want to add?
I would just like to say a massive thank you to all the students, the parents and the staff who've got involved in the productions over the last few years, because without your continuing support, we just wouldn't have been as successful as we have. So hopefully this will continue in the future, and I'm truly really grateful that you've helped me give the students memories that they're going to treasure for life. Thank you.
Thank you, Bethany. Here's a short clip to show our performers in action.
Springwell 2050.
Thank you for joining us for this bulletin.
Enjoy the rest of your term, and don't forget to look out for edition 2 of Springwell TV. It's a goodbye from Charlie Flynn.
And it's goodbye from Josh Holmes.